The gold standard for VR in education is a gentleman named Chris Deedy. He's a professor at Harvard, and he doesn't do goggles-based VR. He does desktop VR, although he's moving towards goggles VR. And what Chris has built is two amazing experiences, one called EcoMUVE, M-U-V-E, and one called River City. And his virtual learning scenarios are organic. You're moving an avatar around and you talk to other avatars. You get to run experiments, and the science content responds to what you do. It's engaging, and you can play it for a long time. It's a very detailed environment to do learning. He's put it in thousands of schools. You know, hundreds of thousands of students have used this, and he's got great data showing that it works. In particular, what Chris and his colleagues have shown, is students that typically have a hard time doing well in science. For example, someone that, I can't be a scientist, that's not what I do, whether it's due to your race or your gender, or for whatever reason, can't see yourself as a scientist. When you're in River City, you have an avatar, you're a scientist, and you're doing science, and it helps those that have a hard time imagining that they can do science. And he's got great data showing that those who struggle typically with science, River City and EcoMUVE typically help them. The challenge now is when you go from that type of amazing learning content to putting the virtual reality goggles on. And that's where I've been studying for about 15 years. I've been working in this area, and it's a challenge. One of my philosophies that should come across very clearly in this book is you shouldn't use VR for everything. There's a lot of things that work beautifully by the written word and by video, and you shouldn't just shove everything into the goggles needlessly. And so what I do in my lab when I design learning content is I think, well, what's gonna be uniquely awesome in VR? And it turns out things that where you actually have to look around, right? So one of the key signals that you can decide that something doesn't deserve to be in VR, if you're watching a user and she's just staring forward the entire time for 5 minutes, and well, then why are you in VR? That should just be a high-res screen right in front of you, and you can have more pixels. What I've been doing for the last few years is trying to really understand what types of learning and learning transfer is uniquely suited for virtual reality. When I began this learning research, I just assumed that the immersive aspects of VR was going to automatically cause a gain in learning, and we're finding it's more nuanced than that.